So Spider-Man does whatever he wants, cause he's got that swagger and he's earning millions through Sony. So this is Marvel's Spider-Man Remastered, Super Remastered, Super Duper Ultra Pretty Edition. So yes, this game is a total feast and a beast from the very beginning, and that's where I ended up because I had to go through this review. The original release was a highlight from like 4 to 5 years ago and one of the finest games released in the last few years. So when you go into this game that's being remastered and optimized to perfection, it's hard to not enjoy it. So pretty much you become Peter Parker and you start swinging across the city right away, and just everything around you is gorgeous and detailed, and the buildings feel full, and like it just feels like New York City, really. And yeah, the world feels real, and the only time it really, the immersiveness shrinks is when you go onto the ground, and that's usually the case, and you walk around. It's not quite so big. There's a lot of people walking around, which was pretty impressive. I got back to the mission, so I didn't really spend a lot of time doing that. But yeah, you get the feeling that you can climb and swing pretty much everywhere and anywhere without any limitations. And even running this game in 4K at max settings, there's just zero lag whatsoever, and I was super impressed. I was expecting some sort of lag happening, but it really didn't, so wow, kudos to them. The voice acting seems spot on, and I don't think it could have been any better from the voices I've heard so far. The writing's perfect, the Spider-Man has some funny one-timers, or one-liners, that keep the game rolling and the mood high and positive. The game takes about 20-30 hours to complete. I'm still in the first hour or so of the game. Honestly, the cons is the game is fun for hours, but it feels like the side quests seem kind of repetitive, unfortunately. The game isn't super difficult. I didn't find it difficult, I was still learning how to be Spider-Man. So even the bosses are apparently fairly easy as well. There's no bonus content, and that's unfortunate. So once you've been the main quest, there's no multiplayer, there's no racing against a second player, unfortunately. So that would have been cool if they added that. So that would have made the game a bit more enjoyable afterwards. As well as, you pretty much, once you finish the main story, you have to or go around taking photographs or unlocking other outfits or doing the side quests you miss. So ultimately, even with all that said, it's hard to come up with anything that's not really good about this game. I feel like at first it's a little bit hard to learn Spider-Man's moves, but like that's such a minor gripe because you really feel like Spider-Man, you're zigzagging everywhere, and it's a lot of fun. But yeah, it really feels like an essential purchase for Spider-Man fans, even if you're just a tiny bit of a Spider-Man fan. It just still feels like a 9 out of 10. It's one of the best games released in the last 3 years. Probably the best Spider-Man ever game ever made. And one of the best games released in such a long time. So anyways, I have to end this saying, look out, don't miss Marvel Spider-Man. And keep on gaming.